Welcome to today's Grow It Green. We are at Sanborn Mills Farm in Loudoun. I'm joined by Rachel Messini of UNH Cooperative Extension. Rachel, you've got a behemoth with you today.
This is quite
the hornet's nest.
It is. Today we're going to talk about three large hornets that we have here in New Hampshire that you may encounter you know, when you're outside. And I just want to clear up on what they look like and what you can do for them if you do run into them. So this happens to be a ball-faced hornet. And this is one of our largest. It's about 3/4 of an inch. They love to make nests like these, usually in trees, but they could be on the eaves of your home. You want to get them when they're small. So they are beneficial in the adult stage because they're out there feeding on other insects. So that's a good thing, but these can get very aggressive. So the second one I wanted to talk about is the cicada killer. The cicada killer is a large insect. It's about 1.5 inches or bigger. They're solitary, so they're in the ground, one per hole. And they hunt cicadas, and what they do is they paralyze it and then stick it into that hole and then lay an egg, and the larvae will feed on that. The third one is a European hornet, and that is the native hornet of Europe. It is very large. It's about 1.5 to 2 inches, and they are brownish in color with brown head, brown body, some stripes, and they are they're active at night, and so they're usually making nests under deck, could be in the eaves of a house, any hole, like a cavity of a tree. And so again, they are very, very aggressive. So you want to make sure you know what you have and then maybe manage them.
And when it comes to that, if I say I'm at home and I start to see one of these nests forming, what are some techniques I can do just at home to manage these?
For the bald-faced hornet, they start usually in April, May to start a nest, and it's one queen. One fertile queen will start something that will grow to something this large over time. So if you see any activity, you can squirt it down with a hose, or if they get to a size like this, I would not attempt to do it yourself. Call a PCO or pest control operator to do it for you.
All right, some good tips there. Rachel Messini from UNH Cooperative Extension, thanks for the helpful tips today. That'll do it for today's Grow It Green.